Memorial.
Good morning, Memorial.
Good morning, Memorial.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Memorial.
I'm Steph.
And I'm Avis.
Today we're looking at the halls and what's happening in Jackson Memorial.
My name is Richard George Vanderstein III, and I am currently with
Vixen Knox,
Kaylin Page Burgle,
Jacob.
Jacob, what is your occupation?
I'm an AV tech here.
Currently, I'm unemployed.
Peanut butter.
Kaylin Burgle, I'm going to be asking you four would you rather questions. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I plead the fifth.
You didn't have a choice anyway. First one would be trapped inside the last movie you saw for 24 hours or be trapped as the killer in a horror movie for 24 hours.
I think I'd rather be trapped as the killer considering it's a giant monster.
Be trapped inside the last movie I saw.
The last movie I saw was the movie The Lighthouse. And I don't know, it was kind of a horror movie.
I'd say the killer.
You're crazy, dude. Would you rather have to show your father the last 10 pictures of your camera roll or have to show your mother your 10 recent search histories?
I'm gonna go with photos.
I'll take the photos.
Pictures.
I'd rather show my mom my recent 10 searches.
That's a very quick answer. Would you rather have the ability to see 20 years in the future or have the ability to see 50 years into the past?
Love to see 50 years into the past.
Future.
The past.
What is your reasoning?
It's more interesting.
Into the past, because 20 years in the future, you could die in the next 2 years, you never know. You see 50 years in the past, you can answer questions that no one else has.
You're an intelligent man with smart reasoning. Now for the last one, would you rather restart today or skip tomorrow?
Restart today.
Skip the inevitable tomorrow because tomorrow's Friday and after that is the weekend. So I'd rather just skip straight to it.
Skip to tomorrow so that I don't have to be here. I can just go straight to the weekends.
Restart today.
Always skip tomorrow. Never.
That's deep. I'd like to restart today.
Girly, you're crazy. All right, well, thank you. I appreciate your time. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Good. Let's take a look what's going on here in the classrooms.
AFG ROTC stands for Air Force Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps, teaching young men and women about aerospace, leadership, and health and wellness. There is no obligation to join the military.
Students should join this program because it's exciting. They get a lot out of it. They get opportunities that they normally would not get, once-in-a-lifetime opportunities. Like, say, how about presenting the colors at the 50-yard line at an NFL game? Because that's what they got to do this past October. They went down there. There was this little venue called Lincoln Financial Field with 67,000 people in attendance. And a lot of noise, a lot of screaming there, and they went out there and they performed while the national anthem was playing. And they got to stay on the field, watch the game, so that was pretty exciting.
So we have a lot of different extracurriculars, such as our drill team. We have a community service team. We have a color guard team, so basically if you're ever at an event you see uniformed people presenting the colors, that's basically what it is during the national anthem. We also have, as I mentioned, we have community service cleaning up our community. That's one of our many programs. We also have we also do a lot of different aerospace stuff involving things like drones and also we launch model rockets, so various aerospace things. And that's just the tip of the iceberg as far as this is concerned.
Oh, we do a lot of stuff. So our biggest thing for our unit is community service. So like in December we hit over 1,000 community service hours in for the unit, and we're trying to get to 3,000 by the end of the semester. So it's a really cool opportunity for cadets to get out into the field and, you know, work with the community. We work at the food pantry, work at Liberty Haven Farms, we do a lot of different things. It's really cool.
How much of a mentor they are. They really do help us out in any way that they possibly can, you know, mentally, emotionally, or with anything in the class, or just anything that we're working on here to keep the unit running.
This is a great unit with a great history. It's been in existence for 44 years. It started here back in 1978. So I just want to continue that legacy here. And Jackson is a great school district. It's very supportive of the program. And you need a district that will support the program to let it do what it's designed to do.
I joined the program because I do happen to really like aviation, and I'm looking to go into the military. So especially if you're looking to become a military pilot, if you're looking to become something like that, this is the perfect program for you, whether it be Navy, Marine Corps aviation, or Air Force aviation, obviously. But anything like that, definitely that this is the perfect program for you. Like I said before, you don't have to be someone like me who wants to be a Navy pilot for me specifically. You don't have to be like that to go into junior RTC and really gain a positive experience from it.
My favorite memory is honestly all the community service that we've done. It really shows that you're making a difference in your community and that people really appreciate what you're doing.
Nice. Come join us in Bikini Bottom March 10th through 12th for our spring musical, SpongeBob. Tickets can be purchased via the QR code on the posters.
Are you paying with cash? Don't worry, just find Ms. Larson doing common lunch outside the band room in room 405.
And remember, seating is assigned, so get your tickets quick.
Hi there, my name's Gavin Lee. I was Squidward in the Broadway production of SpongeBob, and I'm here at Jackson Memorial doing a masterclass with the fabulous SpongeBob cast here. Come and see them on the 10th, 11th, and 12th of March here in Bikini Bottom. Yeah!
Taylor Rashnock with Goodmore Memorial, here to give you the inside scoop on JMHS's latest production, SpongeBob the Musical, Lego.
A few moments later.
Riley, what's your favorite part about SpongeBob the Musical?
I'd say my favorite part about SpongeBob the Musical is that it's very different than anything we've done at Memorial recently. It's very sporadic, there's all different kinds of dances, all different kinds of music, and there's something in there for everyone.
What is so special about SpongeBob the Musical as opposed to any other musical?
It's bright and colorful, and SpongeBob is really fun. Like, all ages can come out. It's not just particular for one age. Like, everyone knows SpongeBob. It's gonna be a great show. Make sure you come see it on March 10th, 11th, and 12th.
So what set pieces has the crew created this year, specifically for SpongeBob the Musical?
Specifically for SpongeBob the Musical, we've put in a lot of hidden Easter eggs of other Broadway shows, of just little hidden Easter eggs that most people should be able to pick out, so it's really fun to spot those.
We've put in some really creative touches in the set. Like, my favorite is the slide that we have.
So how do you feel about being a part of SpongeBob the Musical? Meow. Could you tell me a little about the music?
So it's actually really interesting. The music in SpongeBob, each song is written by a different popular artist that a lot of people may know. So there are songs written by Aerosmith, Sarah Bareilles, Plain White Tees, Panic at the Disco, John Legend, Cyndi Lauper, and a bunch more. And it's great because it's all different styles based on the artist. So there's country music, there's pop music, there's rap, there's rock and roll, and there's something for everyone. So it's really interesting and really different for a musical.
You heard it here, folks. Get ready for
SpongeBob the Musical!
SpongeBob the Musical!
Musical! Come relax and unwind, decompress in room 602 at Jackpaw's Place.
Jackpaw's Place 602 is open daily to all the students in Common Lunch B.
Great way to march into wellness.
Hi, my name is Jazzy and I'm a part of Jackpaw's. The idea is to focus on mental health and the ways that it can affect you. There will be events and a spirit week that will help get the school involved and raise awareness. Wellness Resources Tuesday, which is every Tuesday, that will be held in the community-based resources with tables set up in the auditorium during common lunch, including Harbor House, Dark Correlation, and etc. We have wellness workshops on Mondays during common lunch A, including Get Moving Mondays, Stretching and Yoga, Tea Time at Jackpaw's Place, which is 602, open every day during Common Lunch B, and a new therapy dog that will be coming March 31st, and a daily wellness tip will also be on announcements. March 20th to the 24th, let's make Jackson Memorial High School a place where students' health and wellness is nothing but the best it can be.
Jackpaw
Sarah's Place is a calming, relaxing space filled with coping tools for students. It grew out of really the increase in mental health struggles that teenagers face. This is a room that's for the entire school community. Counseling isn't necessarily the end-all be-all, and it's not necessarily for everybody. So I wanted to increase the tools that are at students' disposal. We're looking to expand upon that in the future so that students will utilize it more. Well, as you can see, we have the fish tank behind us. We have a coloring station set up. We have a table called Soothing Solutions where there's Buddha boards set up. There's some Chromebooks set up that are connected to a website that was created for the room called Jackson Relaxin. And that website has all types of breath work tools and meditation. I think the key is to use it. It really is important that the students take advantage of this resource.
Sounds intriguing.
That's a big word. Do you even know how to spell that?
No, but let's see if these students can.
Good morning, Memorial. I'm here in Fine Arts at the Heart and Center of Jackson Memorial High School. And in honor of the district-wide spelling bee coming up, we'll be asking some of our top minds and talents to spell some difficult words.
Welcome. So I'm going to ask you how to spell a spelling bee word, and you're both just going to answer back. So Maddie, you're first. How do you spell arachnid?
Oh no,
girl. What does that even mean, girl? Definition.
A bug.
Please. A bug. A R A C H N I D E. Okay. So your turn. Can you repeat the word?
Arachnid.
Arachnid. Arachnid. A R A R C H N E D. Okay, so you're both incorrect. Maddie, you were very close. The correct spelling is A-R-A-C-H-N-I-D.
Oh, I was close too!
Both of you were very close, but good job.
Your word is yacht.
I should have a yacht.
Y-H-A-T-A-D-E.
Sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is Y-A-C-H-T.
Well, Spelling Bee is on Tuesday, March 21st at 5:30 p.m. in the Fine Arts Auditorium. And I hope the spellers that we have in there are better than the ones that we had out here. Have a good morning, and go Jags!
Well, that's all we have for the show.
Join us next time for more JMHS News. The top of 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 the top of